Welcome to Lab 360, for all the latest happenings from the world of space. A potentially dangerous asteroid is headed for Earth today, March 24, 2022, according to NASA. This news, which comes just days after astronomers spotted an asteroid hours before it hit Earth, informs that another space object is set to come close to the planet on Thursday. Asteroid 2013 BO76 will swing past Earth at a distance of 5,111,759 kilometers, which is extremely close for NASA to term it as a potentially hazardous asteroid. The asteroid has a diameter of around 450 meters, making it big enough to cause a lot of destruction if it hit Earth. However, the planet remains safe from it since it will just look on as the asteroid goes into its orbit. At its closest, the asteroid will be flying at a staggering speed of 49,513.45 kilometers per hour. The size may seem small, but the high speed with which it is traveling gives it enough potential to cause major damage on Earth if it were to hit us. The Jet Propulsion Laboratory, which tracks near-Earth objects, has released the orbital parameters of the asteroid along with its orbital diagram around Earth that extends beyond the orbit of Mars in an elongated shape. The asteroid, if compared to objects on the planet, has a similar size as the Empire State Building in the United States. The asteroid last visited us in 2013, when it flew as close as 7,888,295 kilometers from Earth. The JPL has said that after Thursday's close flyby, the asteroid will next visit Earth on July 14, 2033. During its 2033 approach, asteroid 2013 BO76 will be at a distance of 19,185,926 kilometers. The latest asteroid flyby comes days after astronomers detected an asteroid with a low chance of hitting Earth, crashing to the surface hours later. The object, which was barely 2 meters in size, entered the atmosphere southwest of Jan Mayen, a Norwegian island 470 kilometers off the east coast of Greenland and northeast of Iceland. The impact was confirmed by infrasound detectors. Asteroids are rocky fragments left over from the formation of the solar system about 4.6 billion years ago. According to the NASA Jet Propulsion Laboratory, JPL, which tracks asteroid movement, an asteroid is classified as a near-Earth object when its distance from our planet is less than 1.3 times the distance from Earth to the Sun. Numerous near-Earth objects are tracked on a daily basis to furnish a premature warning if they shift onto a collision course with our planet. It's pertinent to note here that the course of the asteroid can get easily altered. Asteroid 2013 BO76 on March 24 will join the group of seven space objects that are expected to pass Earth while making a close approach. Fortunately, not a single one of the asteroids being tracked in real time by the space agency is thought to pose any risks of collision. Our planet has not witnessed an asteroid of apocalyptic level since the rock that wiped out the dinosaurs. Let's hope it stays that way. What do you guys have to say? Drop in your comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360 for all the latest happenings from the world of space.
It's late in the evening on the 11th of March, 2022. People all over the world are going about their business, as usual. Out of nowhere, an asteroid has been spotted by an astronomer from Budapest, which is heading straight for Earth. The said asteroid has already entered the Earth's atmosphere. As per reports, it is going to land right next to Iceland. No warnings have been given by NASA or any other space agencies. What do the Icelandic people do? How do they save themselves? This scenario forces us to think about some really valid questions. What is stopping an asteroid from wiping out the human race from the face of this planet? We have the necessary technology available to track these asteroids, but do we have the technology to alter the course of the asteroid? What if the agency that is responsible for warning us fails to detect the potential threat? The dinosaurs did not see it coming until it was too late. What if we are fated to meet doom the same way? As of now, we don't have any guaranteed measures to prevent an oncoming asteroid from hitting our planet. There have been theories circling around, but no one has acted upon it, but it's never too late. So, what should we do if an asteroid heading for Earth is discovered? We don't want to think about the possibility that this asteroid destroys a metropolis or causes a massive tidal wave or a disastrous earthquake. Going back to the original news, an asteroid collided with Earth last week. It landed in the North Atlantic Ocean, just north of Iceland. Many pebble-sized asteroids are drawn by Earth's gravity and burn up in the atmosphere itself, so the news is not surprising. The fact that NASA was able to detect the asteroid barely 2 hours before it collided with Earth was very shocking. Worryingly, NASA would have had no time to, as it was already too late. A man from Budapest was looking at the stars at the Konkoly Observatory when he came across a dimly lit object moving at an alarming pace. Within minutes, he was certain that this object was heading straight towards Earth. Usually, anybody in this scenario would panic. After all, this is a very serious issue. But this man, instead of being afraid, he was ecstatic. The fast-moving asteroid was only 6 feet in length. It was basically the size of a refrigerator. This tiny asteroid was completely harmless. The entire occurrence tells a spectacular tale of an astronomer's detecting ability and luck, as well as the technological prowess of Scout, a key weapon in NASA's planetary defense system. This so-called Scout software that tracks all the near-Earth asteroids and figures out where and when their impacts might occur is usually very accurate, but it was caught completely unaware this time. For bad circumstances, there are viable options available. Nevertheless, these scenarios require more development and testing. Our alternatives vary based on the situation, such as how much time we have and if we are dealing with a large or little asteroid. There were ongoing talks of developing some techniques like medium-distance collision, or a laser beam, or even nuking the asteroid. We need to act upon these measures as quickly as possible, as it might decide the fate of the human race someday. The only reason why we have succeeded in avoiding disaster so far is pure luck. We have the necessary tools at our disposal to see any dangerous asteroids. So, why did our best space agency fail to do so? NASA's planetary defense system is supposed to be the best in the world. Its job is to look for and record near-Earth objects, such as comets, asteroids, and other hazardous threats that could impact Earth. This was a really close shave. If the asteroid had been even a bit bigger, it would have caused sizable damage. We got away safely this time, but who knows what's in store for the future.